Hey everybody, hope you're having a great weekend. I'm up here at our youth room filming the sixth video of our NBC Youth at Home. Seems like forever ago that we were up here filming the very first one and didn't know how many weeks we would be doing this and still going. But there is starting to be some good news that we're heading in the right direction with things. And so continue to pray that very soon we'll be able to get back together again. We've been busy here at the church. We've been doing some improvements and some other things, including we painted all of the walls. In order to do that, we had to take everything off of the walls. And as we did that in the youth room, it was just really cool to look back over the years, some of the cool things we've done. It's hard for me to believe that it's been 5 years now that I've had the privilege to be your youth pastor. And looking back, just for example, at our big summer blowout t-shirts that we've done, our big pool party every summer to welcome in our seventh graders and celebrate the beginning of summer. Look at 2015, kind of a retro tank top we did that summer. We will have big summer blowout this year. I don't know when that will be. It might be later in the summer than we usually do. Look at 2016, was like kind of a 90s rad vibe to it. 2017 was always a cool and really bright. We will have a big summer blowout this year. It might just be later in the summer, but we definitely will. 2018, we ripped off the Supreme logo like everyone else did that summer, but that was a really great shirt. And then last year, Chris came up with this, the Toon Squad, Youth Squad logo. I love that one. And it's always cool when I see y'all wearing these shirts, even some of the old ones around. And so it's just been fun to look back. Also, looking at our LFR pictures, going back to 2015, this was the very first group we took to Lake Forest Ranch as a youth group to student camp. Cool to see those folks, many of who have worked at LFR and off in college now, and good to always see them. Look at how our group has grown, and some people looking a lot younger in this picture than they do these days, adults included. 2017, you can see our group has kind of grown every year. Y'all be praying for LFR. We were gonna have a big group go this year, but we're still waiting to find out that, you know, they're having to make some really tough decisions. Everyone right now making tough decisions about churches and camps and other things, about when to meet and how to meet. And so we'll just have to wait and see what's gonna happen. Be praying for Rich and Nick again, and all the staff there again as they make decisions, and we'll just see what happens. This was last year. Awesome group. LFR has been such a big part of our group, both our unity, our spiritual growth. So as you can see, our youth room looks kind of strange right now. Everything off the walls, everything repainted. Posters and our logos and things gone, which is kind of sad looking back, but also anytime you look back, there's the possibility of looking forward. And we've already got some great ideas of some things we can do to our youth room for a fresh start when we do finally get to be together again. A new start, a new season, and that can be an exciting thing. And so looking back and looking forward is always a good thing. I've got some announcements for you this week. Starting with Lilies, this is the last week of the Lilies Philippians study, the last session on Tuesday on Zoom at 2:00. I'm so proud of you girls that have joined Miss Stephanie on that. Thank you, Miss Stephanie, for doing that study and having a desire to teach girls the Word of God that you know will change their lives. And so if you haven't had a chance to be a part of this study, jump on the last session and catch the last discussion that way. But then also Miss Stephanie can give you the materials to go back kind of at your own pace and work through that study, and you can contact her with questions or just discuss it with her, and don't miss that opportunity. And also, we'll continue to do our Thursday Zoom youth meetup. That's been great. We switched to 2:00 last week. I knew that threw some of you off, but we wanted to be a little earlier in the day and the same time as the Lilies. And again, just to get us together, see each other's faces and encourage one another until we can be in the same room again, whenever that may be. Looking forward to that. This is the last weekend in April, and so we're going to roll into May, and I need to know if you have a birthday in May. So if you could contact me and let me know what the date of your birthday is, we'll make sure on that week's video to acknowledge it and say happy birthday to you. We'll go ahead and tell you about this week's lesson. So a lot of us are saying things right now as we continue to be patient and pray about this, that God is with us through this and God is in control of this. And that's absolutely true. Those are both true statements. Do we really believe that? And so I want us to go back and kind of take a journey through the Bible and look at all the ways and times that God has dwelt with his people and has been in control, and really look at scripture and draw the answer to those questions and strengthen our faith by looking at that. So check your emails and get the study guide for that. And then on Thursday, we'll walk through those scriptures and talk about it together. I want to go ahead and tell you about this week's contest coming up before we get to last week's, because we had some amazing videos submitted. Can't wait to show those to you. This one's going to be pretty easy. I think everyone can participate. And so everyone who does will put your names in a hat, draw it out. I have one more Stillman CD, and I'll throw in an NBC Youth sticker for this. So what you need to do is you need to go back through all the videos, if you haven't watched them already, and tell me how many of the videos and which of the videos that Michael J. Fox appeared in and what he was doing in each of those videos. I also want you to give me an idea, one or as many as you want, of something that you would like to see Michael J. do. And we will feature those possibly in an upcoming video. So that's all you gotta do. Just send me those answers and you will be entered into the drawing to win the CD and the sticker. So this last week's contest was awesome. Thank you to Chris for coming up with it, to have a trick shot challenge. And y'all have been great to participate and to be creative and to send in your videos. And I want to show them to you right now. Here we go. NBC Youth Trick Shot Videos. Go.
Go.
For the week for our youth group is that we have to do like some kind of do perfect trick shots.
Oh, that's cool. Know.
Yeah. Do you want to like do some?
Yeah, sure.
Alright. Let's think of some ideas. Okay, so we need like an intro, but not something super long, like kind of basic, you know?
Yeah. What about this?
Hey, I'm Macy.
And I'm our little brother Josh.
Okay, first of all, I am not wearing that hat for the whole video.
Okay, fine. What if we do a trick shot? Where I throw a comb behind my back.
Where did that come from?
I don't know.
Alright, I see how it goes. Also sorry, but losers have to play away.
Psych.
Honey, open up a coffee table, please. Thank you. Hey guys, I need to clean your room, please.
Aw, man.
Yeah.
Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming now. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Swinging like Ali, knocking out bodies, standing on top like a champion. Keep yourself.
Josh is catching cashews thrown by Jason. Is that?
Give me that gold.
Give us a smile, Josh. Wave to the camera. Peace out. Whoa. God loves you.
Okay, there you go. Great job, everybody, of being creative and challenging yourself. This has been a lot of fun for me to, throughout the week, get your contest entries and be in touch with you. And you did a really, really great job this week. It's always good. The more participation we have, the better it is. And so this was a really hard decision to pick a winner for the 116 t-shirt, to look at all of those, but there was one that I could tell took a whole lot of attempts, some skill, maybe some luck, and the winner this week is Sam McKenzie, throwing the bread across the room into the toaster. Great job, Sam, you win the t-shirt. But I do have to say, I didn't say anything about having to edit your videos, I just said send a video in. I didn't say you had to add music or effects or come up with kind of a storyline, and there was one that went above and beyond, that was Macy Ditchendorf. And so I do want to give you a t-shirt out of the youth closet, an NBC Youth shirt. The next time we are together, you can pick from what we have in there, a t-shirt or a sweatshirt. And I wanted to reward you for that. But good job to everyone. It was a whole lot of fun and looking forward to this week. So I hope you enjoyed this week's video. Hope you have a great week ahead. Continue to be in touch with each other and with us. And know that we love you and we're praying for you. And we will see you very soon. Bye.
We can be here.